Welcome back to Magic Magic TV. My name's Craig. It is 9 o'clock on a Wednesday, which means it's time for a Hidden Gems. And today's Hidden Gems is a personal favourite of mine. Today's Hidden Gems is Shuffleboard by Simon Aronson. Now, I've spoken briefly about Shuffleboard on this channel before, but never in any great detail. I do, however, think that Shuffleboard is one of the, if not the best, self-working trick with playing cards that's ever been created. And here's the thing, I talk about this on the Hidden Gem series all the time, but the problem with magicians is they're always looking for that latest and greatest magic trick. They're always looking for that new release, and they forget about the stuff that's gone beforehand. But Shuffleboard has been around for years. It must be about 20 years old. There's been lots of variations of Shuffleboard over the years. Jeopardy, I remember from Paul Green's DVD in the Trenches, was a really good version of it. There's been, I think, Little Bunny Card Trick, and I can't remember who, I want to say John Armstrong, but I don't think it was, I can't remember. And, you know, in the latest or the last season of AGT, when we had a winner, a magician who's a winner, in the audition or one of the rounds, did a version of Shuffleboard, very clever version of Shuffleboard, but basically the same effect, just a different method. The point is, this is an incredible, incredible trick. And from a commercial point of view, it ticks all the boxes. The only negatives, as far as I can see, is it needs a table, not particularly a close-up pad, it just needs a table. It's a small setup, but you can do the setup on the fly. And I have many, many times done the setup on the fly. However, outside of that, the trick is amazing. The cards are shuffled by the spectators thoroughly. They make all the decisions, or they feel like they're making all of the decisions. It feels completely random. The predictions build from one to the other. And when you're finished, you can either go into any other trick because you're left with a regular deck, or you can just put the deck back in the box and you're instantly reset for the next table with no moves at all. It is an incredible trick. And it's one of those tricks that fools magicians, it fools lay people, it fools everybody. Now, before we go any further, I'm going to show you a performance of this. I had time to show this to Matt in my office. Everybody knows Matt. He works in the sales department in my office, and he absolutely loves magic. So let's have a look at this. This is a performance of Shuffleboard to Matt.
Hello.
How you doing, buddy? You okay?
Yeah, man.
I'm going to show you an amazing trick. I've made a few predictions.
But your famous question mark.
Yeah, it's my famous question mark. I made a few predictions in here. And I know you know a little bit about magic, so I didn't want you to think that like I was hiding extra prediction. It's right there. Everything right there.
Okay.
Okay, I'll put it there. Now, the other thing about this is I have a pack of cards. And I want you to do everything here.
Oh, God. Okay.
Normally, it would involve two people, but you're going to have to be both people. Okay, so first of all, give this packet a shuffle. Mix it up. Very good. And when you're happy, put it there.
How long do we have to make this last before they start
paying? About 10 minutes.
Yeah.
Yeah, try and make it as entertaining as possible while you're shuffling. Shuffle that half as well.
So this would normally be two people.
Yeah, two people
Someone
shuffling.
Does a half each.
Yeah. Gotcha. But you're going to make all the choices. You're going to do absolutely everything. Are you cool?
Yeah.
Put those there. So I want you to cut this packet into half. Cut this packet into half. It's up to you where.
Back on top or leave it?
No, we leave it. So we're going to end up with two piles. That one's quite small. Do you want to put some back on today? You don't have to.
No.
Okay. So now you're going to turn one packet here face up and one packet here face up, whichever one you want to. Okay. And what we're going to do is we're going to shuffle the face down into the face up. And if you can do like one of those things, which I know that you can a little bit. Give them a... Yeah, a little bit. Just give them a thing.
Cop as bad as Luke, Matt.
Yeah, but Luke's...
That's it. And then just... No, that's fine. It's embarrassing, but, you know, whatever. That's good. It's fine. Nobody
Luke's
noticed.
Luke's pretty, though. He can get
Nobody noticed. And do the same with these two.
Oh, God. You put me under pressure on camera.
Cool.
That was a bit bad.
That was all right.
That's not bad.
That's not bad. You're okay. You're okay. Now what I want you to do is turn... So you've made two face-up, face-down packets.
I've made a fucking mess is what I've made, dude.
Turn one of those packets face over. It's up to you
turn
which one.
Turn them over.
Yeah, just one of them. It's up to you which one. That's great. And we're going to do one more shuffle. Shuffle...
Into each other?
Yeah, into each other. Yeah.
Jesus Christ. That's not bad.
That was all right, yeah. So now...
It's shuffled enough that it should make life difficult for
you. You can see that, like, there's cards face up, cards face down. And it's important for you to realise that you made all the decisions here. So you shuffled both packets. You then cut wherever you wanted to cut.
Yeah.
You then chose which packets to turn face up.
Yeah.
You shuffled them face up into face down. Then you chose which packet to turn over again. Then you shuffled those together. You made the decisions. There's no way I could have controlled the outcome here, could I?
That's a mess.
That's a mess that you created.
Yeah. Not for the first
So
time.
Let's look at but the first yes. prediction. The first prediction, I predicted that 23 cards are going to be face down.
Fuck off.
Now, bear in mind, you shuffled them face up into face down. You did everything. So pick the deck up as if you're about to deal. You're
going
to
no
deal.
Way.
Wait a minute. You're going to deal into two piles. If it's face up, deal it there. If it's face down, deal it there. And every time you get a face down card, count it. We'll see how many face down cards there are.
There's no way.
One,
two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23.
What the fuck? You did everything. You picked which piles to turn over. You did all the shuffling. You turned them over again. You were even a cock and you had a really small packet and it's still working well. But hang on, move the face-up cards out of the way, because I did make another prediction. Just get rid of them, doesn't matter. 23 face-down cards. The next prediction was, there are 14 red cards. Now, bear in mind, you were shuffling everything. So, take the deck, turn it face-up, deal them into red and pack, and count the red cards.
That can't... Oh, dude, this is insanity. How the fuck do you do that?
Well, I might not have. Why don't we check?
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14.
The fuck?
That's good, isn't it?
But I made another prediction. That's not the end. I made another prediction. Look, if we unfold it again, I made another prediction. All the black cards are clubs.
No way!
Oh, hang on.
Oh, no, there's not. There's an ace of spades.
Is that the only one?
That's the only one.
Just the ace of spades?
Just the ace of spades.
Let's have a look at the last prediction.
Oh, no.
Except the ace of spades.
No!
Huh?
The
That's a good one, dude. And that was there the whole time.
Yeah.
Nah, got nothing.
You literally did everything.
How the hell does that happen? Because I mixed them all up, right? So I mixed them up, I shuffled them together.
Yeah.
Picked which ones to turn over, picked which ones... It was a mess, man. It was a proper mess. How could he possibly know?
You got me.
There you go. That trick's as old as the hills. That's about 20 years old.
Almost as old as me.
I know, right? Whatever. Now, that is a performance of Shuffleboard. What I tend to do with the prediction is the way that that piece of paper was all folded up is a Paul Green idea. When Paul Green put his version of Shuffleboard out, he did it using that style of prediction, and he put a Jeopardy presentation together, which was a great presentation that I loved. Unfortunately, we don't really have Jeopardy over here in the UK, so it didn't make sense to anybody. So instead, I used the folded up piece of paper, but I use a different presentation, just more of a generic presentation. But if you haven't seen Shuffleboard before, I remember the first time I saw Shuffleboard. It absolutely fooled me stone cold dead. Like, I had no idea how that trick worked. Like, no idea whatsoever. It just completely blew me away. And when I learned it, I was like, oh my gosh, is this it? Because it's self-working, basically. You don't need to do anything. But, oh my gosh, it's so good. And the other thing is, the shuffleboard principle, once you understand the principle, can be used in so many different ways. So I've got a trick coming out with Murphy's later on this year, and there's lots of different aspects to it, but it's a bonus routine. One of the bonus routines use the shuffleboard concept, but in a completely different way. The shuffleboard concept can be used in so many different possible combinations and iterations. It's an incredible concept, it really is. And yeah, it's super commercial. If you don't know it, you can learn it. Like, it's in Simon's book. I can't remember which one. I've got all of his books. I can't remember which one. I'm sure somebody who's more knowledgeable than me will tell me down below in the comments. It's also, as I say, Paul Green's DVD, which is available as a download now, I believe. His version's on there. There's lots of different versions. You can probably find it on Simon. Simon Aronson did a 4-DVD set through L&L. Which is, because Murphy's bought the L&L range, it's available as a download. You can probably go and check that out there as well. There's lots of different places that you can go and check it out. The point is, and the point I'm trying to make, is that shuffleboard is absolutely fantastic. It's absolutely the perfect example of a hidden gem. So if you haven't got it, go and learn it. It's brilliant. So there you go, guys. That's another hidden gems in the bag. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. Do you agree? Do you love shuffleboard? Do you do shuffleboard? What's the reactions like that you get? Do you not do it? And if you don't do it, why don't you do it? And yeah, I want to know. And let me know in the comments down below if you want to see hidden gems done on any other type of project. I think I'm going to hit the Penguin Lives next. Possibly, we'll see. You want to see more videos like this? Like the video, subscribe to the channel. If you haven't already done so, please do me a favor and try the Netricks out for a month. It's www.thenettricks.com. You can go and try it out for a month with no obligation. It's really good, but I'm biased. I'll be back again soon. Thank you very much for watching. See you again tomorrow. My name's Craig from Magic.